Hello, in this series of videos, let us review the concepts of Python programming through quizzes and multiple choice questions. This will help to prepare for technical interviews or exams and enhance the problem-solving skills. Let us see the first one. Which of the following is the correct way of naming variables in Python? In this first variable, it starts with number. In Python, variable should not start with the number. So this is not correct. Then here, alphabets, underscore, and a number are used. A variable in Python can have alphabets and numbers, but the number should not be in the first position. And the variable should not contain any special character except underscore. So this is correct. Here, alphabets and numbers are used, and number is in the last place. So this is also a valid name. Here, alphabets are used. There is a space here. Space is a special character, and it is not allowed. And at is also a special character. It is also not allowed in the variable names of Python. So this is wrong. So the second one and the third one are correct names for variables in Python. So the second one, what does 5%11 will evaluate to this one? Even though this is a percentage symbol, in Python, when you are using print command, this will act as a format specifier. But here, it is a modulo symbol. It is giving the remainder of the division. For example, 5 divided by 11 means quotient will be 0. Here also it will be 0. So the remainder is 5. So for this operation, it will give only 5. 5 is the correct answer. The third one is, what does 4/7 evaluate to? Actually, single slash is used for division. Double slash is used for floor division. Floor division means in the quotient, you will be taking only the integer value. For example, 4, it is divided by 7. So value is 0. Here also 0. So remainder is 4. But in the quotient, you will have 0. But you should remember that when you divide 4/7, if it is 4/7, then it will give float value in the quotient. But 4/7 will give only integer value. So it is 0 only, not 0.0. You may have a doubt whether the fraction in the quotient is removed or rounded off. If 8/3 is to be computed, then 8, 3, 2, 6, 2. So this is the remainder, this is the quotient. Actually, if you continue the division, you will add 0 here, you will get 6, 18, 20, so 6 like this. So in this case, this fraction is greater than 0.5, but it is not rounded off, it is removed. Only the integer part is taken. So the result of this is 2, not 3. Let us see the next one. What will be the output of the following code? Here, number 1 is a string. Number 2 is also a string. So, print number 1 plus number 2 will concatenate the two strings. That means it will be put like this. 100 will be put here and number 2, 200 will be put here. So, this is the correct answer. Now you see this example, the same thing, number 1 is a string, number 2 is a string. Now number 1 is typecast to integer. That means that string is converted to a number. So 100 is a string and it is converted to integer 100. Similarly, string 200 is converted to integer 200. Now if you put number 1 plus number 2, then since these two are integers, the values will be added, it will not be concatenated. So the answer will be 300. Correct answer is 300. The next one is, what is the type of the following expression? 1 plus 4 by 2. Actually, this 1 is integer. When you put 4 divided by 2, it will be float. Now, when you add an integer with float, the result will be a float. So they are not asking the value. They are asking only the type of the expression. So the result will be float.